are general semanticists AWOL in the age of lunacy. AWOL means away without leave. For those of you who are not in the army, whatever. But to be away, you have to be somewhere, and this is where all the general semanticists are. And years ago, they had the winter USA ice skating team went down in a plane. It was disastrous, and so if something happened in this room, GS would make the papers. That's not the way you want to get on the map. All right, by the way, I'm wearing this T-shirt, Thrust. I don't usually wear it, but it was the name of an all-girls band. And so I figured, well, I want you to get the thrust of my ideas. And since I'm not reading from too many notes, I found this on the bus, so I thought this would be appropriate. I'm under a little stress. Okay, I'm trying to be serious, but I have difficulty being totally serious. When I was laid off from the police department in 1975, I left the department before I was ready to leave. So I was a community affairs cop, and I made these cards up, and then I put it on a sheet. There was a demonstration at City Hall. Thousands of cops were blocking the Brooklyn Bridge. I gave a speech. I forget all the words, but I held this up. And you may want to get a picture of this. You've heard of zero tolerance? Well, zero tolerance comes from make zero crime happen here. Zero tolerance is a myth, but making zero crime happen here is an objective, it's a direction. So when I left the police department, they raided my file and they used that, whatever. Anyway, so there it is. Okay. So right now, I just want to tell you, I was wondering what my first words were, and I was going to tell you that I feel like a Jackson Pollock painting. You know, all know who Jackson Pollock is, and so for those of you who know about horse racing, I felt like all my ideas are like the horses in a race. And so some horses are favorites and some are long shots. So which one is going to win, I don't know. Anyway, I also had a drug-free legacy letter published in Newsday 1989 in January. I made copies of it, but I was in a rush, so I forgot it, left it home. But I know the beginning of it, and it's very topical, especially with this opioid business, killing a lot of people and all the other drugs, et cetera, and the poppy fields being untouched by our military, which is sent to the United States to addict people and so on and so forth and wreak havoc. Basically, it's the pharmaceutical companies and the advertising companies program the population to pop a pill at the slightest pain. The drugsters just come in and pick up the cash because, you know, people have been programmed. I don't think enough heat is being given on teachers for instilling. I'm talking about elementary school, you know, before, during high school, whatever. Instilling in people the dangers of addiction and drugs, etc. And I don't think you're going to get the straight news from any of the television networks because they're like junkies. They depend upon the revenue from the pharmaceutical companies, and they're one of the biggest lobbyists. In that letter, I mentioned that in certain countries, you are not allowed to advertise drugs on television. At the time I published it, I don't think they were advertising drugs for all the different diseases. Some are embarrassing if you have your kids around you and so on. And I don't have any kids, although if I get to be rich and famous, I'll find out how many I have. Couldn't resist that joke, sorry. So we need some superstars in general semantics. Lance is one of the biggest, no pun intended, you know. I have to drop a few pounds too. I tell people I'm famine ready and I have to go on the spread yourself too thin diet. Well, anyway, we can't afford to lose Superstar, but I have this for Marty. I use this in shows over the years. Crime is a boomerang. And what I'd like perhaps to have him do is put Institute for General Semantics on the bottom, give it to every police commissioner in a large city and have it in the precinct or whatever. Right now in the NYPD they have CPR, was it community,
courtesy, professionalism,
respect, right, yeah. I promoted an idea, mobilize against crime, but I was ahead of my time. Incidentally, I want you to congratulate yourself because the murder rate has gone down from about 2,000 to about 200 or 300. And I studied general semantics with Alan Flagg before I joined the police department. And I had a TV show, I ran for office, this and that. Rachel Lauer, do you all know who Rachel Lauer was? She created a program in PACE. And I remember being in a seminar with her, and she said, close your eyes and imagine something. So I imagined, well, what the city would be like if the murder rate plummeted. And you know, in some cases, people are not ready for a tremendous plummet in crime. In the troubled neighborhoods of this city, undertakers lost money, the ditch diggers lost money. You know, when the homicide rate went down, florists, fewer flowers needed for funerals. Coffin makers and so on and so forth. You could let that process and sink in. Chicago needs a little work in this area. Here's something that's going to shock you. I stayed away from politics because I feel so comfortable with so many Trump supporters. Why even talk about it? Anyway. But I will say this, that one of the things that Donald Trump has said is we have to know what's going on. So the question is, regarding the illegal immigration and everything else, and I think they found a guy who was responsible for one of the arsons in California. Sometimes it clashes with different points of view. But the point is that Donald Trump needs your help because you're the experts, and he doesn't know what's going on, where it comes from, and how it can enrich our culture, etc. So I'm suggesting that everyone here who has a book, send it to the White House. Because you never know what's going to happen. I'm just looking over here. Is there anything over here what I need to say? Oh, yes. When you were talking, I was thinking of Chicken Little. The sky is falling. But you said some profound things, but you did not mention the freedom of speech that was questioned in Berkeley, where you had a lot of people drowned out, et cetera, et cetera. So when people criticized me, I give them the example of the elephant and a blind man. You're probably all familiar with that. The blind man touches the tail, it feels like a rope. It touches the leg, it feels like a tree. So it really depends upon your point of view and your perspective. I practice general semantics every day. I tell people about jaywalking, they say, hey, it's New York. But you know what? The murder rate went down to 200. So if the murder rate goes down, why not wait for the light to turn green and look around and research and see how many people buried in their phone with a stroller walking through the red light while the kids are taught green light in school, and meanwhile the parents just don't do it. So I congratulate the people who are waiting. I tell the kid, give your mother a raise, she's a role model. Or I sometimes say, this is called weight training. Now I know you're all anxious to have your lunch, and does anybody know what a honeymoon salad is? I'm sure some of you know that one. Lettuce alone? That's an old one. All right, I'm sure the vegetarians here don't have a beef about me shortening my talk. See, I didn't even get any fingers. I'm glad I didn't get the middle finger when I mentioned Trump. Thank you very much. I don't know. I think I'm sure I'm missing. Oh, yes, I forgot to tell you last time. My father was a nurse, but my mother never nursed me. Here's something that everybody should have. I didn't bring enough for everybody, but sometimes I'm in the hospital area in Yorkville, and I see a couple of nurses and doctors, and I say, hey, doc, can you help me out with this? You know, it's good with dogs, too. You get the, I say, oh, your dog passed the test. You put it on your money talks. It's a great gag. It changes the atmosphere. When I was a cop, I had it in my hat, and I would press that. One time I had a guy in Bellevue, and the nurse said, you know, he's going to get more medicated. He's going to say that cop's hat is squeaking. But anyway, thank you for your attentiveness. So the question is, are general semantics AWOL in the age of lunacy? The answer is no, but they have to step up to the plate. All right? And it's a perfect segue to lunch. Step up to the plate.